Today, friends, I'm going to show you how to make a part like this in just a few minutes using Tinkercad. So let's get cracking. This is Tinkercad.com. If you've never used it before, I suggest sign in with Google. This is the basic workspace. Right here is where you can find all your designs. They are saved to the cloud and they are all private unless you choose to make them public. If you want to make a brand new design like we do, we're going to hit Create 3D Design. Now the first thing I do is name a project, that way I can find it later. That reminded me a bit of a handle, so I'm gonna just put the word handle for what it's called. And in Tinkercad, we build with solid shapes. There is a torus. There is also one you can search for called the HD torus. It is a little bit higher resolution. I'm gonna choose to work with that one. I'm gonna click on the old one and hit delete. I'm gonna click on our torus and I want you to notice its properties. Right now we're working with the radius. That would give it a diameter of 20 millimeters. I'm gonna pretend that thing was 25 millimeters. So I'm gonna type 12.5 for the radius. If we zoom in, you'll notice the sides are rough. We can make it look more smooth by just bumping up the numbers. I'm going to take this radius and I'm going to make it 2.75, not because I know the exact number, just because I want you to see how we adjust it. And then once again, let's adjust the sides so it's maximum smoothness. Taking a quick look at the image of our part, you can see I just built this piece right here. All right, so we've got our sweet tube. Let's move to the basic shapes. Bring out a cylinder. I will show you quickly, if you set it on top, that's called cruising, and it lands on whatever face you put it on. We want to set this one down on the work plane. If we look back at our shape, I've got three different angles. You can see there's the hole, that's the edge, this is the other end, and we can see here that we need a gap between the little bumps and that edge. So I'm going to quickly bump back to our design and let me show you how we get that gap. I'm going to take this and I'm going to shift grow it. And then I'm going to type the number 15 in here and press enter. That snaps it to 15 on every measurement, which is a cool way to adjust things. Now we're going to do L for align, pick this one as the master, make it the middle of these three. I'm also going to look at this from a corner and choose the middle of these three. Now I'm real close to smaller than the design. I'm going to get it even closer by holding down shift and squeezing it inside just like that. Since it was from the top down, it scaled around center. I could have also used Alt-Shift and scaled around the center from any of these handles as well. Now, I do want this to be taller. I'm going to say the right height is something like 35. I do want you to know that you can click in the box and type the perfect number instead of dragging handles too. Next up, we need to make these ridges. Let me show you how slick that is. We're going to simply bring out another cylinder. Notice this one is rough. We're going to bump the sides all the way to the max of 128 to make that one smooth. And then I'm going to make it 2 millimeters thick. Once again, instead of trying to nudge it, you can just type the measurement. If we move this inside, I'm going to pick a different color. Once again, just showing you everything that's available. We're going to select it all and do L for align. And we want it to be center and center. Now, obviously, these bumps are sticking out way further than they were on the other part. So I'm just going to nudge them back with the black handle. I do want you to know the black handle makes this easy. It goes 1 millimeter at a time. The white handle, and if you make a mistake like this, just do Control Z. I'm going to click back on the green shape. The white handle does 2 directions at once. So it's a little trickier. Of course, I wanted to show you that so I could do Control Z again. I'm going to raise this up because those do go all the way to the top. Easy to snap it to the 35. And then this trick is called duplicate and repeat. I'm going to click just on the green part and do Control D. And then when we rotate it, we need to pick the degrees smartly. I'm going to choose 15 degrees because I know that goes into 360. Now, if I let go and don't touch anything else, I can do Control D again and again to get that to go all the way around my shape. Now, I'm not actually holding the real shape. If you had that real shape and are making it, I would try and measure these and get it exact. I would also count how many I need. For this project, I'm just showing you how that duplicate and repeat works. Next up, we need to trim this edge, and we're going to do it with the bottom part of our project, but turn it into a hole. Check it out. Control D. Control up arrow to raise it up, control shift up arrow to make it faster, switch it to a hole, and then we simply need to change its measurements. I'm gonna say that I want it to be 10. Notice it turns red as it's calculating. That looks pretty smooth, but I do wanna make sure it's halfway. Once again, if you make a mistake, just do Control Z. I'm gonna change my nudge to 0.1 and go Control Up. A couple clicks, once again, just trying to get that halfway. Select it all and do Control G to group. Notice the red lines mean it is thinking, but bingo, there is a version of our part. Now, once again, if you needed this real part, you could measure and double check and get it perfect. I do not need this part, so I am not gonna go any further than that. We do need to cut a hole in the middle. I'm gonna do that by cruising this out. I am gonna cruise it right on top. And the reason I'm doing that is because if I shift shrink from the top, about the same as what was in the picture. I think this is about the right amount of area. Once again, if you had the real one, you would measure it. I'm gonna change this to 35 because I know that's our number. And then when I click down here to get rid of what I call the living work plane, we can hit D to drop. Our part is now in place. I'm gonna look at it underneath. Notice we do need to fill this area in. We're gonna do that real quick with another cylinder. Shrink it down to the right height and just set it inside there. Once again, we can grab it all, do L for a line, and choose center and center. These parts up here on the original part, if we take a peek at them, notice how they look tapered. I am not sure if they are just worn out or if they're really tapered, but let me show you real quickly how to add a tape. We're going to bring out the paraboloid. We're going to make this one a hole, and we're going to do Control D. Make the next one a solid, and I'm going to use Alt-Shift to make it larger. So notice it's got a hole inside. I'm gonna select those two and do Control-G, and I'm gonna turn that into a hole. Now I can bring this over to our shape, select the two, choose L for a line. Of course, we want it to be center and center. Notice those dots were hiding inside. And then we can simply use Control up arrow to raise that up until it's cutting the way we want. There you can see it's only cutting the edge. And if we look real closely, that is about the exact spot where it trims. I'm gonna go to that spot right there. Once again, if you had the real part, you could do some real measuring and make sure it was absolutely perfect. This is called an inverse hole. It is a solid that we turn into a hole, and then we use that to trim the outsides. If we look underneath, you'll notice that I do not have the hole all the way cut through. We're going to quickly ungroup, and I'm going to make sure that this comes down a little further, and then we're going to simply regroup it with Control G. Once again, the red lines mean it's thinking, and after a moment, bang! You have got a part that you needed built in Tinkercad. How cool is that? Friends, there you have it, a fun part using an image, or if you're actually holding it, you could measure and make something similar. Please, if you get a moment, tell your friends. Everybody can learn 3D. Have them check out the channel. I have got beginner lessons where you'll make something useful or fun the first time you open Tinkercad. Of course, friends, I also want to say thanks to all of my supporters via YouTube memberships. There are three different levels, and of course, all support is appreciated. I also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There's an awesome discussion area. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.